Hey guys, it's the Boulder 7000 back more Final Fantasy? No.
What?
Mega Man 5. I got confused because they're both 5. Remember in the last episode when I said I didn't want to fight this boss? Well, guess what? I'm recording the next episode, like, literally 5 seconds after I stopped the last one, so... I'm not listening to myself. So let's fight this boss, shall we? We're at the end of Miley Stage 2, and this thing is a big fucking circle that looks really dumb. And this thing basically flies around in a set pattern, and it's really annoying because it's... really hard to figure out exactly what you're supposed to do for this guy. Basically, he goes in a set pattern. It goes in a figure eight like that, but it shoots balls out. It's like, what? And then it does this, and it shoots a projectile left and right, and then it does that, and then you just kind of gotta fly opposite it and not get your ass kicked by its projectiles that go everywhere, and then they're a nightmare. Shit, I might actually die here. I think I'll use an E-tank if I... I don't know if I can take another hit. Yeah, I think I'm actually gonna use an E-tank, because I got 6 of them. Of course, I also have 9 lives, but if I die here, I know I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back to, like, because the checkpoints aren't nearly as merciful in the Wily stages. They don't give you... They don't spawn you at the boss. Look at that shit. That's the second time I've done that in this LP. Using an energy tank and then beating the boss without taking a hit after that. Jeez. Well. Is she running a bath? My mom's running a bath at midnight. What the hell? Anyway. Third stage of Dr. Wily is really short. It's basically just the Robot Mastery fights. This is kind of why I wanted to, this is why I wanted to have... why the fuck can't I talk? This is why I wanted to have the, I wanted to split the episode where I did in the last episode so that I would actually have, like, anything to do in this episode. So, I don't remember how these guys are arranged. This one's actually different, because usually they put 2 capsules at the bottom, and then they don't have anything in the middle. But, obviously that's not the case here, so whatever. Oh, it's gravity, man. I'm gonna try to use Star Crash on this guy, but honestly, it actually is harder to use Star Crash on him than his actual weakness. Well, not significantly harder, but it is a little bit more awkward than just using... Because the thing is, his projectiles can destroy your Star Crashes, which basically means you can't hit him with the Star Crash, which is stupid. Also, you probably want to save your Star Crash, because that's the weapon used against the boss of this stage, like the boss proper. But it's not much more useful against him than it is against... that was pretty slick. Than it is against... what's his nose? The charge kick is an interesting thing in Waves Man's case, because it isn't actually that much more useful on him. Well, actually, it's pretty freaking awesome, isn't it? Dude! Jeez! Anyway. Yeah, the charge kick, I don't know, whatever. I think that's the only time I've ever used it. It can actually be pretty useful, probably, for getting through areas without needing to deal with as much crap. Don't switch your weapon before you go into the boss, because you don't know what it's gonna be. It's Stone Man.
That's Stone Man. I use Stone Man. It's a common mistake.
Let's use my napalm balm. The warmth of my napalm balm. The warmth of my napalm. Yeah. It's about as easy as Stone Man always is, so whatever. Starman. This guy's weakness is really hard to use against him, because he's weak to Water Wave, which travels along the ground, but this guy jumps, like, all the time. The thing about Water Wave, though, is that it actually gets rid of his star. It gets rid of his star shield, so you can use it to basically, like, completely halt his movement patterns. Which makes him pretty easy. I guess it does work on him more than the Mega Buster, anyway. Crystal Man. Oh, no, I gotta fight Crystal Man. I don't wanna fight Crystal Man. Mommy, I don't wanna fight Crystal Man. Gyro attack. T-attack! Fuck. The good thing about this guy is that if he jumps and you weren't like expecting it, you can angle the shot up into him, which is like, oh man, it's such a useful ability, but really it doesn't make a fucking difference, man. He's dead, oh man. I don't know what it is about that music, but it's just so perfect for the little, like, 5-second interludes between these fights. This guy's weak to Crystal Eye, no biggie. The thing about the gimmick to Crystal Eye is that you can actually shoot it at a wall, and it'll let loose 3 ricocheting projectiles, but I wouldn't recommend that you do that, because it basically just means that you can't hit this guy as often. And I think the ricocheting projectiles actually do less damage, too, so... pretty much no reason why you'd ever want to do that. But why would any woman want to do that? There we go. Napalm Man is gone. The warmth of napalm. Don't switch your weapon before you go in, because you don't know who it is. You moron. Oh, great. Charge Man. This guy's weak to... as if this guy wasn't enough of a pain in the ass, the only weapon he's weak to is the most awkward weapon in the entire Mega Man series. Yep. Ow. Oh, no. Don't charge, you piece of shit. I told you not to charge. What the hell did I just say? I told you not to charge, and what did you do? You fucking charged. Dude! Get away from me! I need you to stop. I told you to stop. Anyway, he's dead. Honestly, the thing about the weaknesses in this game is that, like the Mega Buster, you can't get hit while you're charging it, so which means you have to go a little bit of time without getting hit to be able to do more damage, which actually, now that I think about it, is a pretty radical way to do the fights, you know? And finally, Gyro Man, who is weak to Gravity Hold. Hilariously enough, I'm pretty sure it takes an entire bar of energy to kill this guy. Yeah, because the Gravity Hold does exactly as much damage to him as it takes energy to use the Gravity Hold. So, it's like super inefficient. Anyway, he's dead. And there you go. We're done this stage. Now we can fight the boss, who is, like, supposedly weak to Star Crash, but it's really hard to hit him with it. This is a tricky boss. This is the Wily Press. Basically, what he does is he jitters back and forth, and eventually the cockpit will open, and yeah, that'll happen. The ceiling, him and the ground will press together, and that's basically all there is to it. But it's really awkward, and because the Star Crash projectile is so fucking humongous, it's really easy to hit parts of him that aren't vulnerable, thereby, you know, not allowing you to actually fucking hit him, which basically sucks. The other thing is, like, if you need to jump across here while it's pressing, you're liable to get caught in the underwhoop and basically have the spikes move up into you while you're jumping across, and that's no good. Anyway, this guy's pretty easy, though, because he doesn't have any projectiles. If this guy had projectiles, now that would be hard. That might actually be interesting if this guy had projectile attacks that he could use to disrupt you while he was doing this crap. This crap! But he doesn't, so he's easy. Oh, my game is lagging. Excellent. And he's dead. And you're dead. Yay, so happy. Probably the most forgettable Wily intro theme that Mega Man has ever known. Even Mega Man 8's Wily theme was more memorable than that. That was the one that went... Anyway, Wily Stage 4, I'm pretty sure all of note in this level is a couple of those laser walkers. Yeah. Man, I've never killed those guys that easily before, jeez. And here we are, like, literally, that's the whole stage. We're at the boss. Actually, no, we're not. There's another one, I think. There's another laser walker, yep. Okay, I thought we were at the boss. My bad. My bad, heh. Yeah, here we are. Wait, what? Is this the... what the fuck? Okay, this is the boss. I thought you fell into this boss fight. What the fuck? I could have sworn you fell down into this fight. Maybe that's Mega Man 6? Anyway, this guy's really easy. Basically just, okay, he's not that easy, but it's definitely one of the easier Wily Machine fights. Just use Super Arrow, just shoot it into him. Maybe I can ride the last one into him. Oh, nope, okay. And here's the final boss fight. This music is awesome. The trick to this fight? There's actually 2 tricks. First of all, the way you would do it if you didn't have beat, so I'm going to use my M tank here, which I'm already in the process of doing, but I'm just saying it now. Get out your gyro attack, wait for him to appear, and then shoot up at him. But you got to be fast, and you got to make sure you're not beneath him. But okay, I'm going to try and get one hit off that way. Yeah, but yeah, see, he, like, as soon as he, like, you basically have, you have to get it, like, right when he appears, because he disappears, like, right away, and it only does one damage. The gyro attack only does one damage, so it's also, like, really tricky to do that. Shit. But the trick is, what you can actually do is you can use the gravity hold to show where he's going to be, and with that, I don't know if you can actually, hey, you can get him with a Magabuster shot. I don't know when he reveals that he when he reveals where he is. Yeah, now he moves, but he's in a place I can't reach, so I have to, maybe I can hit him. I might be able to hit him with Star Crash. Nope. I managed to block one of his projectiles. Oh man, you can destroy his projectiles. Oh no, that's pretty good. Okay, I can only destroy one of them, but still, just ugh, shit. But the trick is, use Beat. Beat is the secret to this fight. If you don't have Beat, get fucked, basically. The trick is, sometimes Beat will go after Wily, but he'll fade away before he can, and then Beat will fly to where Wily's going to appear next. And if you can get him into a pattern doing that over and over again, this boss basically proves absolutely no challenge at all. But otherwise, this guy can be a real problem if you don't have Beat. Thankfully, we do. And I'm not sure it's possible, as long as you don't go into Proto Man's stage without getting all the Beat letters, you can revisit Robot Master stages to get the letters after you've beaten the Robot Masters, I think. I don't think they would make it permanently missable, but then again, this game only takes, like, you know, a few hours to play through, so it's not like it would be some huge, you know, thing if you miss something and have to play the whole game again. It's not like if you miss something at the beginning of, say, Final Fantasy X, and you have to play through, like, 30 hours of cutscenes and crap to get back to where you were. You know, if you miss something in this game, you just, you know, whatever. Got one health left. Let's finish him off. Gotcha, bitch. Huh, it actually changed me back to Beat's colors when I beat him. This is hilarious. It's goofy-ass chase music. And it goes on for so long. But we did it, and there's Dr. Light. What's really funny is, as soon as the fanfare ends, the goofy music starts back up again. Oh no! Man, strain, Mega Man! Strain! Strain your body, Mega Man! Proto Man! He saved us somehow! He shot the thing in that minute not fall? I don't know, it doesn't really make any sense, but oh, we got crushed. Oh, there he is in the bottom right corner. He's watching. And Wily got away. We're in, like, the Grand Canyon somewhere. That is also not a hidden place for a fortress. Wily, you suck. Oh, this credits music, man. I love this credits music. Da 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 da. Something about this credits music just screams, like, this isn't the end, our life will go on. Like, so, I don't know what it is, but something about this credits theme just feels like that, like, this is the end of this journey, but we'll be back and there'll be another journey, you know? Forever. That's kind of the vibe I get from this song. Forever. Da-da-da. Napalm Man. The warmth of her palm. The warmth of her palm. That's probably getting really annoying. So what was the final one-up count? Oh, gee, I don't even know. I think we probably had at least 6 drops since the last episode I put up. This was gonna be like 5 parts. So pretty much the same as Mega Man 4. So that would be like 12? 14 one-up drops over the course of Mega Man 5, which is ridiculous. And the journey continues. I think that's the trope. And the adventure continues. That's the trope. Yeah. And the adventure continues. The trope for when, like, an ending ends off with, and then they continued adventuring and having cool adventures. There you go, fans. Write some fanfiction. I should make a Mega Man fan game once. I have a kind of a fan game, but it's like a crossover also. It's called Odd Man, where basically it's like the story, it's like a different setting that's completely unrelated to regular Mega Man, and the main character is like a purple Yoshi android. And, but yeah, I mean, I got like, there's like a whole Robot Master Rogues gallery there that's original, with, for a certain definition of the word. They're all based on items from different games. Like, there's Shell Man, who's kind of Koopa inspired. Oh, I love this. Beat comes in and does the star wipe with Capcom. Anyway, so that's it for Mega Man 5, I guess. Gee, it just kind of happened. What do I do next? I guess I'll just go on to Mega Man 6. And then I can go on to Mega Man 1, then 2, and then 3. Everybody's favorite, 3. I might machete order it. It depends on which one I feel like playing more, Mega Man 1 or Mega Man 6, which I can pretty much guarantee, just based on how much of a pain in the ass Mega Man 1 can be, that I'll probably play 6 first, but I'd like to end on a high note, and Mega Man 3 isn't the way to do that when I'm the one playing it. I do not like Mega Man 3. But I'm gonna play it. I mean, it's good, and I enjoy playing it, but I have more, like, squabbles with that game design-wise than any other Mega Man game. And that's one of the only Mega Man games that I really have no fucking clue how to fight the Robot Masters in. Like, I don't know what it is. I mean, some of them, you know. But that's not what I'm talking about. We beat Mega Man 5, hooray, Wily's at it again, he's gonna get back up to his old tricks, we used Beat, he's a cute little birdie, look at him flapping there. This screen is another screen I stared at for a long time on my 3DS, just kinda soaking in the look of it, you know, flying through space with a bird and this music, this forever music. Like that ending chord there, I don't know, something so like simultaneously resolved but also unresolved. That's how stupid of a description can you possibly muster, but I don't know. 8-bit music theory, you want to do an analysis of this song? It'd be fascinating to hear your opinion on it. Seriously. So yeah, Mega Man 5 is done. Mega Man 6, Mega Man 1, whatever, I don't even care. Get back to doing Final Fantasy 5. I need to record that for tomorrow morning, but I'll probably just record it in the morning because I'm a fucking idiot. So yeah, see you guys later when I do what I do. Bye!